Well, welcome back to the Steve Rob Show. Okay, so this is part three of the outhouse build. And today I went and got $125 worth of supplies. I got 7 2x4s and I got a sheet of plywood. And I got 3 sheets. Well, I call them aspenite. They're called some kind of corrugated strand board. I don't know what it's called, but I always call them aspenite up here. They've changed the name. I'm not too sure what it is, but I'm going to show you what it is. So we're about $325 into the build now. So let's take a look and see how far I got today, and take you off the tripod. Let's take a look. Okay, so there we are. And so you can see I got her all framed up there. Not too bad, eh? And right down here is where there's going to be a toilet roll dispenser. So I put a, you can see the screw on the top side, and I put a screw on the bottom side. So in the inside, I can actually see where I'm supposed to put my fastening to, because once this is covered up on the outside, you'll never see that. Now there's a reason why there's a hole there, and one over there, and one there, and we're going to get to that as we get on with the build. But that's the back of her right there, and I'll show you the side. Same thing with that hole. That hole is there for a purpose. And yeah, so it's pretty well the same thing. And over here, I'm going to have a coat hook. So you can see I got a screw here, and I got a screw sticking up over here. So on the inside, I can tell where I'm going to fasten my coat hook to. Because of course, on the inside, it's not so easy, and the measurement's not so easy to do. And that's about it. So yeah, it's called OSB. Geez, I haven't got a clue. I don't know where this aspenite come from, but I think it was called aspenite years ago. Okay, so there she is there, guys. And that's the toilet seat area there. And I got her all wrapped with tin on the inside, because if you bring women up to your camp, they're going to pee all over the inside of your outhouse something fierce if you don't wrap it with tin. So that's it. I just got some tin. I had this left over from the last project, and you'll see what that looks like later on. But here's the inside here. You know, and comes around, and there's the roof. Now I still have to build a roof for this. And that's going to be another part of the project. I have to build a roof. I have to build a door. I have to build a doorway. So she's coming along pretty good, guys. Okay, so let's see where we can get coming up soon. And there's my little sawhorses that I work off of. And okay, guys, we'll see you on the next clip when I got more done. Okay, so we're back on the build again. The big outhouse behind me. I went to Home Depot and I picked up a whole bunch of supplies, $225, but they made a mistake. I picked up 2 boxes of flooring, and it's like this click flooring you put together, and it was on sale for $17 and change. I get to the counter and I pay for everything. I go back out to the truck, I look at my bill, they charge me $25 and change. So of course you got to go to the return center. So I go there, and I don't know if it's like this in the rest of the world, but in Ontario it's like this. In the big chain stores, when they use a bar scanner, if they make a mistake, up to $10 of the item when they scan it, like all the grocery stores mainly have this. Princess Auto does not, surprisingly. They don't go along with this. But of course, Canadian Tire, Home Depot, Lowe's, all the big chain stores, if they make a mistake up to 10 bucks, you get it for free. Just the first item for free. And if it's over $10, well, of course, you get it for the right price, and they take $10 off. So one of the bundles actually only cost me $7 and change plus tax, instead of $17, you know, and change plus tax. And the other one, they had to refund me the difference between the 17 and the 25. And I thought that was pretty good. I got a pretty good deal there. But yeah, we're into, I'm just going to say, about $200 more today. So that's 325, 525. I think I can build this for 700 bucks. So we'll see how far we get. I'll show you what I got so far, but first, Canada Post just showed up with a package. And I've been planning this job up north at the camp and refacing the whole camp, so I had to go buy some concrete screws, the Tapcon screws. Well, they come with different names. Some are called Simpson, some are called all different brands. But when I go to Home Depot, they're $40 a box. And I just thought I'd take a look on Amazon and see what it was from Amazon. Guys, they were $34 shipped to my door for free because I had another item in there for a couple of bucks more. And I might even show that when it comes in. So I'll just open these up and I'll just show you. Yeah, I could have bought them for 40 bucks at Home Depot, but I thought, you know what? Why not? So this is them here. It's a Simpson brand. And I'll open them up for you, just so you can get an idea of what I got here. Okay, so this is them here. I don't want to tip them all up here. But this is them here. So it's going to go through a 1.5 inch 2x4. And then it's going to go into my concrete wall. And they gave you a bit with it too. And I don't think I'll be using that bit. I don't think so. But yeah, so that'll be another project this summer, hopefully. And yeah, so I mean, I got this head on it here. Now, guys, I've tried the Phillips bit head on these. And for some reason, unless you got a really good bite on it, it just constantly slips all the time. You know, it just burns out the bit. So I thought I'd go with this and maybe just, you know, use a wood bit and just countersink them a bit. But we'll try that. We'll see how that works out this summer. But I'll take you off the tripod and I'll show you what I got today. Okay, so this is that that click flooring I got. So I got two bundles of that click flooring. And then I got some vents. So I got two big ones. I got three small ones. Love the PL Premium, the big tube. Some monocaulking. And I had to get some nails. Now these are just regular, you know, common framing nails, 2 inch, and that's to put the Hardy siding on. So this is the siding that I like to go with. It's called Hardy siding. And guys, if you don't use at least a 6D nail, it'll just bend trying to go through that stuff. So yeah, this is the siding I'm going to put on it. And that siding was over 40 bucks. I think it was $43 a sheet. And I got two pressure treated 2x4x8 footer. And I'm going to be working along with this, and when this is all installed, I'll get back to what I got going on, and hopefully the doorway here will be all finished, and then we can work on the roof. And I have to put a solar panel on there, wire that up and everything else. So we'll see how much I can get done and how much I can show you, because we had nothing but rain so far this year. Nice sunny day today. I'm going to take advantage of it. Okay, so I'll get back to you when I got more. Okay guys, looks a little bit better now. I'm not too sure if you can hear me or not, but I'm just having a little bit of a refreshment. I'm allowed to have a break. Okay, I'll show you what I got done so far. But I just got to finish off nailing this. And it'll demonstrate a little bit better, you know, how good this nailer works. So let's get to that first. Okay, let's just nail this right up. Okay, so there we go. I'm gonna show you what I got done so far. Let's see how square this thing is. Okay guys, this is it right here. That's not too bad, eh? So that took me about an hour to do. And you can see I got a pressure treated board on the inside on both sides. And that's just for the exposed wood that's going to be shown. And on this side over here is going to be a bit of a control panel, and I'm going to have a light switch in there. So let's take a look at my level here, and let's just see how square this this building is here. That's not too bad, eh, guys? Let's put it on this side here. Looks pretty good to me. For somebody who's not a carpenter, it's not too bad. I mean, the building's not all cockeyed and everything. Okay, guys, I'm not doing no more for the day, but I thought I'd answer a couple of questions here and have a nice little sip of my favorite Wells IPA. Okay, one of the questions was, does the pass load framing nailer jam up? No, I haven't found it jamming up. I find that long as you keep it clean, there is service to it. You got to oil it, and it's very basic. So no, I don't find it that it jams up and that kind of stuff. Another question was, do people up in Ontario have regular flush toilets? Yeah, they do. They got regular flush toilets. Where I am, it's in Northern Ontario, and even the people in Northern Ontario do have flush toilets. They have all that kind of stuff. But when you go to a remote area, it's outhouses, and I've built lots of outhouses. This here I'm trying to build on the, I would say, on the cheaper side. I think I can do this for about $700, maybe $750, but in some places in the world, it may cost more, and some places may cost less. But when I find when somebody says to me, can you build me an outhouse? And I say, okay, something similar like this, $1,000. And if they're a couple hours away from me, a couple hundred bucks for delivery. And you know, now you have to dig a hole. You have to. There's more to this than just building the outhouse. There's the part under the ground and that kind of thing. And I haven't got into that. Maybe sometime I will. But yeah, a lot of people, when you say to them $1,000 for an outhouse, they're going like, wow, that's way too much. I mean, you know, they could build something for less. Well, go ahead and try. Yeah, you can build like a real crappy one, like the one I'm replacing. I built that one that I'm replacing. Uh-oh. What was that? Oh, that toilet seat fell down. And I built one that, this one here that I'm replacing. And I built that in 2002 for about $150 . Threw it together because I didn't have nothing up there. So yeah, that's a little bit you know, difference in price, but of course everything goes up in value. And for a lot of people, when you say, you know, you're gonna be $1,000 for an outhouse, how much time was another question I've got into this so far. Guys, this is day 3 and I'm spending roughly 6 hours a day on it. So I mean, to charge $300, you know, for labor, it is really not a lot. I mean, you get your car fixed, it's $125 an hour up here, or more. So I think that's not too bad so far. And for me, I don't make this out of a living or anything. I just do this for my friends and people who want one. And of course, I gotta bring my trailer back from up north. I gotta load it on. Maybe I'll show you me loading the trailer on, that kind of stuff, and how I actually put it on the trailer, take it off the trailer, that kind of thing. But thanks for joining me along so far. You know, this isn't a stick-by-stick build on how you build an outhouse, but you guys will have a pretty good idea. And all these were framing studs, so I never had to cut any of these studs. You know, the building is going to be about a little over 8 feet tall right now. And I never had to cut any of these framing studs. If you buy 8-foot studs, yeah, you're gonna have to cut them all, but these are not 8-foot studs, they're framing studs. And so, yeah, I would say anybody that's got a little bit of, you know, mechanical carpentry ideas at all can build one. And the door here is gonna be all homemade, and I think you'll like it. And I gotta paint it and everything else. So we'll come back in the next segment where I got a lot more done, and hopefully you guys enjoy this. I mean, I didn't want to put, you know, wall-to-wall outhouse builds one after another, so I'm kind of mixing them in there a little bit at a time. So thanks for joining me, everybody, and I hope you're enjoying this. And for you guys that have never seen my channel before, subscribe if you like. Come back again. Thumbs up, guys. And we'll see you on the next one. Let's see what else I can get done and, you know, hopefully wrap most of this all up. And I think you'll like what I'm going to do on the inside. So there you go, guys. Take care.